Welcome to the Daily Reminder Network.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to the Daily Reminder. Bismillah walhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi wa ba'd. When Prophet ﷺ, the news of his uncle's death came to him, he left the majlis he was sitting in and he went straight to his uncle. And he sat right next to him on his bed. And he said to him, Ya am, qul kalimatan uhaju bika inda Allah. Say one word, one sentence, La ilaha illallah, so that I can argue on your behalf on the Day of Judgment. As Prophet ﷺ would tell him that, Abu Jahl from the back, he would interfere and he would interrupt the message of Prophet ﷺ. But Prophet ﷺ did not respond to Abu Jahl. He kept going on and kept repeating that same sentence, قُلْ كَلِمَةً أُحَاجُ بِكَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Oh my uncle, say one sentence so that I can argue on the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you so that he enters you in Jannah. Lo and behold, what happens is Prophet ﷺ is repeating that, but his uncle dies on kufr. And he says the statement that I am on the millah of Abdul Muttalib. I die on the deen, on the religion, on the way of my father Abdul Muttalib. Prophet ﷺ, he gets up very sad and he starts seeking forgiveness for Abu Talib. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he reveals the verses and prevents Prophet ﷺ and tells him not to do this. And then he says,
لا تهدي من أحببت ولكن الله يهدي من يشاء وهو أعلم بالمهتدين.
إنك لا تهدي من أحببت. That indeed you, i.e. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, do not guide the one you love. ولكن الله, but Allah سبحانه وتعالى يهدي من يشاء. Allah is the one who He guides whoever He wishes to guide. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us guidance. Now in this guidance, this particular story has a lot of lessons for us. First and foremost, when a da'i, he's calling people to Islam, he's calling people towards the message, tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Quran, seerah, whatever it is. It is going to happen that there are going to be shayateen from insan, from jinns, that are going to interrupt his cause. As we find over here that he's trying to give the message and you find Abu Jahl, he's interrupting, constantly interrupting. But Prophet ﷺ did not stop his mission. He did not turn to Abu Jahl and say, listen, I'm doing something very important, be quiet. The message for a lot of the du'ats is when you start your da'wah or when we start any form of da'wah and calling people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not get distracted by a few people that start criticizing you, that start telling you that you're wrong or distracting you from the main mission. Get your vision and mission right and carry it on. The next lesson we find is Abu Jahl. He has an exceptional ability to play with people's emotion. We will not only find that in this particular story, but another story quickly I'll mention you, that what happens is one of the leaders of Quraysh, he sits down and he says, I'm not going to go out in Battle of Badr. Abu Jahl, he calls one of his servants and he says, can you bring a mibkhara? Mibkhara is basically that thing that the Arabs use to burn wood or sandalwood or oud wood or anything like that. He brings the mibkhara and he puts it right in front of this person and he says to him, Bakhir, Bakhir fa innaka min al-nisa. Sanctify yourself, indeed you are from a woman. You are one of the women. So obviously he's playing with the man's emotion, with the man's emotion. Similarly, in this story, you find that, you know, as Prophet ﷺ is giving him the command that come and say La ilaha illallah, he would remind the person, play with the emotion. What are people going to say? Does it matter what people say after you're dead? No, it doesn't. For at this particular stage, he's not going to be able to change anything. But he's playing with the emotion that you want to be remembered that you died on the deen of your forefathers and you did not leave your religion. And because of that, you find that Abu Talib, he even in one of the other narrations, he says that I know, O my nephew, that you are on haq. And there would be nothing more beloved to me to put the coolness of your eyes, to give the coolness of your eyes by me accepting this Islam. But I'm only afraid that my nation are going to make fun of me after I die. Hence, I die, I'm not going to accept your Islam. Now, the next lesson we find is Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he goes out and he tried all his best, and that was the mission of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to save every single soul from going into hellfire. The revelation comes and tells Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you do not guide the one you love. And the message here is for parents. The message here is for brothers and sisters, or for relatives. If you have any of your relatives that are not on guidance, that have left the deen of Allah, that have, they're still Muslims, but they're not really practicing Muslims. Remember that all you can do and the best thing you can do for them is to make dua, because guidance comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And lastly, a very important message over here is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over here, he certified the love of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam towards his uncle. And we all know that his uncle died on the in a state of kufr. And subhanallah, over here is where a lot of Muslims, they get confused. Can you love a kafir? Look at what Allah says, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ. Prophet sallallahu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, O Prophet of Allah, you will not guide the one you love, i.e. your uncle. He was a kafir. So what is this love? This is a natural love that you and I have, a humanistic love, a mother's love towards a son's love towards a mother, a father's love towards his son, grandfather. These relationships, they transcend over any religious boundaries. And this is what Islam teaches us. This is specifically what Islam's teachings is. Unfortunately, in today's day and time, that is lost. With this, we come to an end. I hope you benefited from these lessons. Don't forget to subscribe and share these videos. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Donate now. Go to www.thedailyreminder.org/donate and stay updated by joining our network's social links.